rotate the blower to throw and drag the cylinder. I'm not worried about that because it's not going to turn anything yet. So, get through there. Now, what you want to do is you want to flip these down and you want to lift your dancers all the way up to their held position. So now, you don't have to thread this all the way up and down. You're going to thread the film on top of each one of these rollers. Okay? So let's go ahead and push this back. Let you thread this through. So go over the roller, in between. And you don't have to get it all in there right away. But once you start pulling on it, it'll come through. So before you go any farther, let me just give it a quick visual. Straight through and go over the yellow. Go under the black crossbar.
Over the black crossbar?
Go under it.
But over top of the yellow.
And then over that one, and then yes. You know what? You're going to go over this roller up here. You got one roller up top you're missing. Over that, and then under two rollers that are on the bottom here. So here you might want to pull some extra slack. Now you'll come straight up along the side of the seal bar.
In between.
Now,
in between that bar underneath?
You gotta come right on right where my finger's at.
The door! Where's your finger? Okay, under the bar.
So you stuff enough to get up in there, and then you can come and grab it from the top.
Gotcha.
Or if you want to get a stick or something, or to push it up even more. I got it. Now, what you're going to want to do is get more film in the system because the film is very tight and you don't want to be bending these rollers, so get more film into the system. In other words, pull some more out from here. Slip ball. Now you can come up here and pull this out.
You don't need it to feed in there.
And then the flat up. I'll leave that right there. So, now I'll leave that like that. And while you're in here, you might as well lift this up and lock this in place. Put that down first. Now bring it up. There you go.
Okay.
Now you want to go put the top on. You want to pull this out first.
Get this top out.
Nope, right here. Lift that. Make sure the thumb's going off the top. Push it in. Watch your hand though, so they don't pinch yourself. Make sure it's locked in. Okay. So, now you want to kick that. Get in the running position.
Watch your fingers.
Okay. Now you're going to do the same thing. You're going to go directly right over this roller and put it to the side. So you got this piece of angle. It's got to go on the roller inside of that angle. Feed it from the sides a lot easier. There you go. Now once you start that, now start spinning this. As you push that in, you gotta make sure you got it in between though. You don't have any between where it won't grab you. You kind of gotta watch, so you gotta kind of hold pressure in there and spin it. And it'll draw that. You can try to pitch your fingers trying to push it through. The top is too hot. So now, I mean, you got enough that you should be able to pull it. It's going to come in. It'll feed it in by itself. All you got to do is get it started. So, now you're going to go through the dancer, straight on the three stationary, go straight through. Make sure you go over the yellow. Go over the other yellow. Go over that box. Now come over from this side, just pull it straight through. Pull it so this all gets nice and, you know, you work all the creases out of it, flat it up, keep pulling. Okay, now send it through here. So, now you're leaving both the dancers in their locked position so you keep the thumb relaxed.
Yeah.
Right? Now you're just going to get the film set up like this, and then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take this, one 1,000, two 1,000, three 1,000, four 1,000, five 1,000, and I'm going to pull this out, alright, now I'm going to go ahead and flip your dancer. Flip that up, leave that upside. If you want to go ahead and feed some of it in, you can, but it'll feed itself. You can usually let the bottom one go, and then go ahead and do the top one. Now with the top, I like to give it a little extra run. Down. Now you can go ahead and close it. You're good. It'll feed itself. You want to close your guard doors, reset the machine. Never run with these in a balanced position. Wake up the HMI, and you look at that, it'll reset because that prox is made. So let's broke the reset, so press reset. Now, if you press cycle start, you'll see that each one of these will run individually until the prox on the other one, until that flag no longer is blocking that prox. Go ahead and press cycle start. They're both running down again. Okay, so now you're set up with that. Now, especially when you're running this 28 inch wide film, you pretty much got to be dead nuts because it's a 28 inch wide seal body. So what I would suggest is setting it up to run about four or five in a row, no gaps. Let it push through, let it find itself, and then it should be tracked and you should be ready to go for your singles. We'll pull them all out on the end. So if you do that,